everybody. It's really a pleasure seeing you all and being with you this morning or this afternoon or this evening, whenever it is you're all doing your exercises. Welcome to my house. This is our basement, our kids' playroom. Not our kids, excuse me, I'm much older than that. Our grandkids' playroom. So we've taken it over and moved everything out, Don and I. And hopefully this will be helpful to you during this rather difficult time in our lovely spring. So let's keep our bones strong. Let's keep our balance improving and exercise together. Before we start, let me mention a few things. I imagine that many of you do not have weights at home. So I want to show you what I have used and what I would recommend to you. You can always use water bottles and lift a pound initially, but you do want to improve your weights and increase your weights so you can increase the size of your muscles and help develop your bones, or at least maintain the bone density. So, dumbbells you all know about because you've used them at the senior center. Remember, the senior center, I kept telling you, bring more than one set of weights in, more than 2 pound weights or 3 pound weights. And the reason is because, and I never demonstrated this to you in class, but while I would find this really easy, this is a little harder. And if I add a strap to it, a wristband on my wrist, this would increase it by 2 pounds. I have a pink one someplace that I want to see right now. That is a 1 pound band. So I can make this as heavy as I want it without having to have a set of 10, 11, and 12. I have an 8, which I sometimes increase to 9, but you do want to get several of these. And then for your ankles, you're going to help yourself by just doing exercises to the side, front, back, but you'll help yourself much more if you have an ankle cuff. And I'm not a salesperson by any means, but this is the band I've used, the ankle cuff I've used for 8, 9, 10 years. It's called All Pro. I've told some of you about it before. And this one I don't necessarily recommend unless you're one of the more advanced students, but this is a 20 pound one. And it doesn't mean you'll be lifting 20 pounds. It means you might be lifting 1 pound. You put these in and remove them, but you can gradually increase your weights with just one unit, instead of having to buy a 2 pound cuff and a 3 pound cuff. What I recommend is a much smaller one for most of you, which is, oh, that's my big one too. I have a 5 pound cuff that I was gonna show you. This is a 1/2 pound weight. This goes in the 5 pound cuff, and it comes with 10 of these. So if you want to use 1 pound, I recommend starting with, for the new people, none, one, or two, depending on your level of ability. And you can work up to 5 pounds by adding these 1/2 pound units. So you do want to try to get some weight so you can really help yourself. But right now, you can start exercising and you can improve your strength again. I'm sure very few of you have been exercising in the past, how long has it been? 3 weeks, 4 weeks now? And it's good to get back to it, but everybody has lost some muscle density, muscle strength right now, so you do want to start slowly again. And because of that, we're going to start with 8 repetitions of these exercises. Some of you will progress very rapidly, and you can go up to the 12 reps we did, or because you have more time at home, we're not limited to the block of time we had, you can do 2 sets of these. So you can go through the exercises and then go back and do a second set. So if you've been doing the bicep curl with a twist, or bicep curl with a twist, when you finish, you can do it a second time for 8. Or you can work up to 12 and work up to 16. Start at 8, but plan on going to 12 or even 15 or 16. But you want to get your muscles to the point where you feel like, I can't do another one, which I would feel after one, doing a tricep exercise with my 10 pound. I don't think I can do it very well. I couldn't really even do one. But you want to get to the eight, feeling like I can't do any more, or you need to use slightly heavier weights, with heavier weights, or do a larger repetition, larger number of repetitions with a lighter weight. But in any case, the goal is to get your muscles tired. All right, so also make sure, get water before you start. You have to keep hydrated because you will warm up a bit as you exercise, okay? So take a sip. Make sure you're wearing your athletic shoes again, closed toes, closed backs, and make sure you're in a room where you have, this is not a good example, it's not a real sturdy chair, but make sure you have a sturdy chair to hold on to or a sofa, okay? We'll start with a warm up and we'll go right on to balance and we will do upper body and lower body in the same way, all right? But start now. We'll start marching in place till the music comes up. Roll your shoulders. And toe first. Try to get your arms going for an aerobic workout. That'll be good for you too. And while moving, I can tell, heels, heel front. If you feel too tired, don't do all the reps, don't do everything until you do this for a few days or a week. March in place. We need side steps twice to each direction another time. Ready? Did I say side swipes? If I did, I'm going to say side steps. This is real good for balance. It's helping your muscles get stronger here. March in place. Let's do right diagonal, left diagonal. And face me in a different way. Anyway, follow me in the direction I go. And this way. And back. Front to diagonal. And to the other side. And the other direction, whichever way you're going. You can make these as big as you want, the biggest space. But don't overdo the first few days. Again, up, side, down, side again. Side, down, side again. And ready, we're going to do front side, back side with our legs. We're going to do two slow, four fast. Unless that's too much, and we just do them all slowly. Own timing. Ready? Front. Side. Back. Side again. And if you can, faster. Front. Side. Back. Side. Two. Three. Four. And to the other side. Front. Side. Back. Side. One more slow. And four fast, if you can. One more. March in place, and let's swim. The crawl. Long, slow, full rotation. And backstroke. Breaststroke. You're pulling through the water. And the butterfly. Again, get your arms moving in preparation for upper body. Let's do some lunges. Other leg. Keep the leg strength. Other side. Let's get our knees and elbows to meet if you can. You only go as far as you can. If you want to go to here, that's fine. If you want to go here, that's fine. Just keep moving. Nicely done, everybody. Okay, let's go to some balance. I'm going to stand by the side of the chair. And if your balance is fine, you can do that. If your balance is compromised in any way, then definitely come to the back of the chair so you can hold on to it with both hands. We're gonna do, I'll turn the chair this way if I'm behind it. Again, as I've said, and I'm gonna explain it again, there are some new people who were in the class near the point where the center closed. We'll do heel raises. I could lift my heels, if you can see, a half an inch off the ground, and I could pretty much hold my position. But if I come up higher on my toes, you'll see I have a little more difficulty. So we want to strengthen our leg muscles. That's going to help prevent falls. So we want to try to go up high. Some people can't go up that high. Just go as high as you can go. But it's better than being down here and thinking I'm balanced when you're barely off the ground. Remember that you have your feet shoulder width apart when you stand at home. You're probably not going anywhere where you're going to be standing in line right now. Well, you might be. I'm not. Keep your legs shoulder width apart. So you're standing up tall. Bring your shoulders up, back and down. Rotate your thumbs out. You can do either of those to get your posture. Always try to keep your ears over your shoulders, over your hips. When you're like this, you're already off balance. So you want to make sure whenever you're standing anywhere that you're standing as upright as you can. Picture yourself pulling your head up towards the ceiling and lengthen your spine. Okay, for those of you who are more advanced, you don't have to hold on to the chair. You can do it coming up and coming down. For those of you who have real balance problems, you try to keep your hands right above the chair. Give yourself a chance to relearn balance and to strengthen your legs by keeping them hovering up there, but right there where you can grab them. All right, so let's do two of these. We're going to go up to the count of four, hold to the count of four, and come back down to the count of four. We'll do two of these. Okay, ready? Check your posture. You're looking straight ahead with your ears over your shoulders, stomach's pulled in, and one, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Very good. Again, two, two, three, four, hold, count with me, five, six, seven, eight. Now we'll do the toe raises. Everything applies here too. You don't want to come up like this. This is very hard for some people to do. They just can't get their toes up, and that's okay. We get stiffer as we get older. This is going to help loosen that muscle. But what you don't want to do to get your toes up, if you lean back like this, you're going to get your toes up, but you're not really helping your muscles in your legs, and you're not really getting your legs, your ankles, more flexible. So keep your body straight the whole time. If you can't get them up high, if you can get them a half an inch, that's great. Just work towards getting them up higher each time, okay? So we're gonna do two of them, up to the count of four, hold four, and down to the count of four. Everyone counting with me, please. One, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, down, two, three, four, two, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, down, two, three, four. There's a tendency to look down and check out your feet and see what your feet are doing, but you don't need to do that. You will feel the muscle action in the back of your legs. So as long as you're feeling that pull and that stretch, that's all you need to do, okay? Just make sure you're keeping your head upright. That's very important to do. All right, let's do the tandem stand. So, and this one, toe to heel. Again, your posture. Check your posture. A really good way to get that posture is to put your thumbs back a bit. I'm going to move my chair a little bit. Okay, your weight is balanced between your two feet. You're not leaning forward on the one foot, and you're not leaning back on this one. The point is to test, is to challenge your balance. I could stand like this, but if I stand in the middle, it throws my balance off a little bit. If I lift that foot, I'm going to fall. If I lift my front, when I'm balanced in the center, I'm going to go forward. So you're right in between the two feet. And let's bring our hands up to the count of 10 and down to the count of 10. For those of you who have balance issues, hold on to the chair. You can start with one arm going up. If that's too hard, then keep both here for now. And just, again, try to loosen your grip sometimes. For those who are very advanced, it's just this and down without holding on to anything. Find a focal point on the wall that'll help you keep your balance too. If your balance is great, you can look around the room while you do this. Whoop, I just started to lose my balance. So when you start looking around, it makes you work more towards holding it. So pick whichever one you want. We're gonna do eight of these, okay? No, we're not doing eight of these, excuse me. We're gonna go up to 10 and back down and then change feet. Ready, and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and down. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Very good, let's reverse the feet. Get your balance, check your posture, pull your stomachs in, and you're right in between the two feet. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, and down. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Very good. We'll now tandem walk. For those of you who want to do this at home, you can do this. Just make sure you're near something you can grab onto, your sofa, if you can grab onto it. Sometimes just walking along a wall so you have it there to touch gives you a better balance. So just make sure you're near something. Don't just walk out in the middle of the room, please. So what we're going to do, oh, actually, I won't go there so you can see me better. You're just going to, again, walk as if you were in the tandem stand. If that's too difficult at this point and your balance is compromised, but you want to do that, you can just walk. Try to act like you're walking a tightrope, but you're not putting your feet together. Like that. No toe to heel for the people who have balance issues. You're walking like this. If that's too hard, walking a tightrope, then just try to get your feet a little closer together. I'll try to go this way. Let's say you normally walk like this and you want to challenge it a little bit. Consider how far you're bringing your foot over. If it's really hard to walk, then you can do it like this. And then gradually bring your feet in closer and eventually get to the point, if you could see me, where your feet, your toe is touching your heel as you walk. So we'll just, right now, we're going to do five forward. For those of you who have balance issues, do your five forward, turn around, and go back five. For those of you who have good balance, five forward and then walk backwards, the other five. Okay, ready? Check your posture, ears over shoulders, and one, two, three, four, five. Now, for those of you, I'm going to add one more detail again. For those of you who have great balance, challenge yourselves, because you don't get better unless you challenge yourself. So when you go forward or backwards, you can swing your leg as you do it. You can lift your knee as you do it. You can pause as you do it. So do whatever you need to do to challenge yourself. All right, and so we're going to go backwards, except for those of you who need to turn around and walk forwards. Again, near a wall or near a sofa. One, two, three, four, five. All of these balance exercises we're doing, you can do every day of the week. You can do it 2 days in the week or 3 days. That's what I'm saying, 2 times a day, 3 times a day. So make sure you do it. You'll really find that one good thing that will come out of this whole experience we're having in this country, in this world, is your balance will improve so that when you start going out, your balance will be much more stable. All right, let's get to chair stands. And I'm going to do this on an angle so you can see it better. Most of you know this, but there are some new people. So your feet are shoulder width apart. Anytime you stand at home, your feet should be shoulder width apart. Okay. you're gonna, you don't want your knees to go beyond your toes, that can damage your knees. So you wanna lean forward, make sure your feet, your toes aren't going over your knees, and gradually stand up to the count of four, using the full four counts, not going one, two, three, four. Not going one, two, three, four. It's a very slow rise, steady slow rise, till you get to four, and on four, you're at the top finally. And let's do eight of these. Ready? Oh, one more detail is, if you're one of the beginners, you can push your hands off the chair, or if you've just gotten weaker because you haven't been exercising this last month, you can push off with your hands. If you feel like you want to use weights, just be careful right now, because I don't know how strong your leg muscles have remained. So it may be good for everybody to start from scratch in terms of just standing up without weights, unless you're convinced you're really strong. All right, and then we'll, since we have time at home, we'll lean back for two, pull your stomachs in, your abdomen in, it'll help tighten your core muscles, and that actually helps protect your back. So, here we go, one. No, it's not, we're not ready to go. Weights, when you get to the point where you feel your legs are strong enough, I won't grab mine right now, you can hold weights, either cross them in front of you, hold them here, hold them on your shoulders, whatever you're most comfortable with. So I'm gonna put my hands here right now as if I had weights. And we'll count together, please. Anytime you're using weights, we need to count. Helps keep your body, your brain oxygenated. All right, keeps your blood pressure down. One, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, back, two, three, four, two, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, back, two, three, four, three, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, back, two, three, four, four, two, three, four, hold, five, how you doing? Six, seven, eight, back, two, three, four, we're on five, five, two, if it feels like too much, stop. Four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, back, two, three, four, six, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, back, two, three, four. Don't use momentum here to get up. Don't come from here to this. Make sure you pause a bit. Seven, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, back, two, three, four. Last one, eight, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, back, two, three, four. Very nice, everybody. One more detail about that. Make sure, when I said when you're coming forward, don't lunge forward. You can actually make yourself fall. And I thought about something else I wanted to tell you. When you lean forward, don't lean way over. You really don't want to do that. You don't want to lean much more than here, where your face is and nose are over your toes. That's a kind of line physical therapists will use. Because when you start going further, you're prone to falling sometimes. So protect yourselves as you do these. And again, if you have any question about your physical condition, you can still call your doctor and say you wanted to start this up again. Is that okay? This is what I'm experiencing now. Make sure that your body can do these things. I have to tell you, I felt that in my knees. I've been doing, I think twice a week, the upper body and lower body. And well, not even balance. That's what I've been doing to make sure I protected my bones. I felt that in my knees this time, and I'm sure you did too. I think you did too. Not I'm sure. So just listen to your body. If it's too much, doing the eight, then cut back and just wait and increase it as you get better. All right, so those are the balance, basic balance exercises. Let's now go to upper body. So I'm not going to bother using my arm cuffs just for time. Let's start with, what's our favorite? Oh, we should start with, because of, I'm feeling, this is nighttime here, and I felt that. Okay, because Virginia loves this one so much, oh, I don't want to use this for this one. What am I doing? Let's do the hug a tree. A hard one, very hard one, so you're not using a heavy weight here. I'm not, this is probably too much for me for hug a tree, maybe not. Okay, ready? Feet are shoulder width apart, and you're reaching forward to hug a tree. One, two, three, four. This isn't good, I can't show you this. Let me turn this, sorry about that. On this one, remind you, you don't want to bring it back all the way to here. You don't have to. So you're starting here again. One, two, three, four. Squeeze your back muscles. Five, six, seven, eight. Two, two, three, four. Squeeze. Five, six, seven, eight. Three, two, three, four. Squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. Four, two, three, four. Squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. Five, two, three, four. Squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. Six, two, three, four. Squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. Seven, two, three, four. Squeeze, five, six, seven. You counting? Eight. Eight, two, three, four. Squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. When you do these, make sure that your arms are as if they're on a table and you're coming back this way rather than dropping your hands. People have a tendency to drop their hands as they're doing that. Okay, let's go to the legs. Actually, I'm gonna give you a break from your arms. I want you to grab some water. I know I'm getting thirsty, so take a break, take some water. You can hear my water bottles chirping. Okay, let's get your leg cuffs on, your ankle cuffs if you have them. Remember, if you get this one, for those of you who have this, there's a little notch that goes behind your leg over your heel that helps protect the Achilles tendon. So we are going to start with the side leg raise. Actually, I need the chair this way. No, I need the chair this way, sorry. You can do this at the wall too if you're doing it at the chair. Don't do what I'm doing, please. This is dangerous, but to save time, I want to just move on. If you're going to the side, lean into your chair a little bit to keep you upright. You can do it at the wall. I don't know if you can see me over here. You can lean into the wall a little bit. It helps you stay upright. You don't want this to happen because you're not working your body correctly. You need to stay upright. And there's a tendency, because you are putting all your weight on this one leg, to lean. And you want to work this muscle through here. So if you have your hand here, you can lean into the wall with your hand a bit. That helps keep you in an upright, totally upright position. And the same thing is true when you use the chair. You can use your arm to support it a little bit. Toe must be pointed straight ahead. Watch my toe, please. You're all looking directly at me, so you can see me pretty well. Your toe points straight ahead. If you go this way, if you point your toe out, it's easy to get your leg up. If you keep it straight ahead, I'm stopped here. My bone stops me. I can't go any higher than that. And you'll feel it. You're going to feel it in both sides. And that's good for you. If you feel sharp pains, stop immediately and give yourself maybe a few days or even more. You don't want to feel sharp pains anywhere in any joints. That's a warning sign. It's the red flag your body's sending you. So watch for the pains. Okay, we're going to do 8 of these. So check your posture, ears over shoulders, over hips, over knees. And 1, 2, 3, 4, hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 2, 3, 4, hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. Very good. 3, counting out loud. 3, 4, hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, no toes this way. 3, 4, hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. 5, 2, 3, 4, hold. Check your posture. 6, 7, 8. Are we on 7? 7, 2, 3. I need you people. 4, hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. 8, 2, 3, 4, hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. Very good. Let's go to the back leg raise. I'm going to bring the chair back over here. You can do this again at the wall, at the chair. If you're at the chair, you want to try to get about an angle like that. When you lift your leg, you're trying to keep your feet parallel all the way up. Again, you don't want to turn your leg up. You're not working the right muscle. You're doing some good, but we're really trying to increase bone density as well as strength. So, I know some of you like to do this, find that easier, that's fine. If you have a sloping chair, that's going to be pretty hard, but that's fine. So you can try those things. At the wall, you can stand at the wall, you can rest your hands. If you have wrist problems, this is especially good. You can just rest your hands and just lift the leg behind you. You want to feel it up through here, all the way down. So you know you're doing it enough and correctly when you can feel that. You're straining the muscles, increasing strength in the muscles. They're pulling on the bones, and that's getting the bone to react and build. So let me do it here for a little, and we'll do it at the wall, a little outward at the wall too, whichever you prefer. Okay, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, keep your head on the same line. 2, 3, 4. Hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. Look 2 or 3 feet out. 3, and count with me. 3, 4. Hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. 5, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. 6, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. 7, 7, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 5. Can't hear you counting. 6, 7, 8. Last one. 8, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 5, 6, 7, 8. Very good, everybody. If I didn't tell you, I want to remind you to lower the weights. Start at lower weights than you had when you left the center. Your muscles aren't as strong, so make sure you don't start at that weight. Okay, we have the front leg raise. Don is telling me something again.
Other leg.
Yeah, we'll do the other leg later. Okay, let's do the front leg raise. We're gonna do it standing. So again, you can do it at the side. If you can get your leg up underneath the chair, you can. Sometimes, this one doesn't allow me to, but sometimes it gets you right to the point of about 8 or 9 inches, which is about the highest you can go. But you can easily do this to the front. So you want to try to get between 6 and 9 inches off the ground. Okay, ready? I'm going to bring this here. It's a little easier for me if I have support on that side. 1, 2, posture, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 2, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8, 3, 2, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8, 4, 2, I'm getting thirsty, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8, 5, please keep counting, 2, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8, 6, 2, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7, 2, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8. Last one, 8, 2, almost there, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8. Very good. We are going to switch to the arms again. And let's do the tricep. So, those of you who are new, most of you know what form is best for you. If you have any shoulder issues, then you can do it sitting down, where I don't have anybody who's going to say to me, you forgot to do this one exercise. I hope Don's keeping good track behind the camera there. Start with your hands by about your knees, lean forward slightly, and just raise your arms behind you. And it's working your tricep right here. So you should feel the tug. So raise it until it's comfortable, but you can feel the tug. You're raising to 4, and then you're coming back to this position. Ready, and. Sorry. That's for the people with shoulder issues. People with shoulder issues can also do it standing, where you get in a position, you lift your elbow as high as you want it to go, and then you don't move anything except your elbow. If you're down here, you're not going to do much for your tricep, but you may have to begin in this position, but eventually you do want to get up higher if you can. So the only thing moving there is the elbow, so you don't strain your shoulder. If that hurts you, then be sure you do it seated. And the third one that can be done if you have good shoulders and feel so inclined, you can do it sitting if you want, but it's good to be standing, is you bring your hands up. Sorry, just wanted to check our ceiling here. You go back down to the count of 4 and back up, keeping your elbows as close as you can. This is 2. Well, maybe it's not 2 because other people may not be ready. So we start together. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 5, 6, 7, 8. Knees slightly bent. 2, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 2, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8. Keep going. 4, 2, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8. 5, 2, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8. 6, 2, 3, 4, hold, 5, you counting? 6, 7, 9, 6, 7, 2, thank you, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8, last one, 8, 2, 3, 4, hold, 5, 6, 7, 8, very good. Let's take some water. Everybody? You should be feeling thirsty. If you're counting, you're getting a lot of air into your mouth and you should be feeling thirsty. Plus, you may be getting warmer. And if you start to get warmer, you also need more water. Excuse me. Okay, let's do the bicep curl with a twist. That's not a good way to pick up weights. Ideally, since we're at home, we can store our weights on the chair and not have to bend forward. When you have osteoporosis or osteopenia, you don't want to be doing what I did. I used my arms to help support my back, but I'm better off having, unfortunately I didn't do it to show you, having the weights up higher, which you can easily do at home. It's in this place where you will usually use, just have it set up so your weights may be on a counter and you don't have to be bending down. When you put your ankle weights on, you can have a chair and lift your foot up and not have to bend over in that way. Okay, bicep curl with a twist, where bicep curls are this, hammer curls are this, hammer curl, bicep. This is doing both. So we'll start with this. I should have my ball. I don't have my ball with me. If you have a ball, you use it here, put it between your legs. Oh, Don, can you roll that soccer ball to me? Back there. Thank you, thank you. This is not the kind of ball you want to use. You want to use a kid's toy ball. This is too big. But as you're going up, you're squeezing because you're working the inside muscles there. They're called adductor muscles. And we're using our leg to the side. We're working the abductor. We're looking. No, there are only toy balls down here. I don't think. So you're using this ball in this exercise. Ready, and one, two, three. I'm squeezing my legs. Four, hold. Five, release the ball. Two, three, four. That will count. Wasn't whatever. Let me start over. It's one, two, three, four. Hold. Five, six, seven, eight. I was given instruction and lost my train of thought. So here we go. One, two, turn. Three, four, squeeze. Five, six, seven, eight. Your arms, I'm going to interrupt again, stay at your side the whole time. There's no swinging back that gives you momentum. Okay, two, two, three, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. Three, two, three, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. Four, two, three, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. Five, two, three, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. Six, two, three, four, squeeze, you're counting, five, six, seven, eight. Seven, two, three, four, hard work, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. Eight, last one, two, three, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight. Very nice, everybody. Get rid of your ball, you're done. And let's switch our cuffs to the other leg. By the way, these cuffs often come with two, which is what I have. And you can really put on the cuffs on both legs when you start exercising. But I wasn't sure what all of you had. So I decided to do it that way. So we're going to go back to the leg raises. And I'm doing all three of the leg exercises on the same side, because eight is not a very high number, and I probably shouldn't have done that with all of you, but that's what it is. And I think you got through it, right? Okay, let's do the side. Again, you can do it at the wall, whichever you prefer. Ready, and one, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Check your posture and count. Two, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, three, two, toe pointed straight ahead, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, four, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, five, halfway there, two, three, four, hold, you're doing great, five, six, seven, eight, six, three more, two, three, four, almost there, hold, five, six, seven, eight, only two more, seven, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, you're gonna feel it, eight, eight, feel on both sides, two, three, you're helping your bones, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, and you did it, great job. Don't forget, you're improving your bones and your balance at the same time, so you're doing great. Okay, let's do we'll finish with the sitting front leg raise, and you can do either the sitting or the standing when you do these. Okay, back leg raise, here we go again. Okay, ready? And one, two, three, glance out about 2 or 3 feet in front of you. Five, six, seven, eight. Two, two, three, four, hold. Make sure you're counting. Five, six, seven, eight. Don't lift your hip. Three, hip stays down. Two, three, four, hold. Five, six, seven, eight. Four, two, three, wish you're all here. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Five, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Six, three more, two, almost there. Three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Only two more. Seven, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Last one, eight, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. You did it, great job. Now, let's do two variations. When you're doing, watching this video, when you're doing the front leg raise that we did we do that with this side too already? I'm losing track. No, we didn't. Don shaking his head no. Let's do the front leg raise. But we're gonna do it differently this time. We're gonna do it eight, where you bend your knee, and then we're gonna do an alternate sitting down, okay? So right now, let's do eight, bending the knee. Just come up as high as you can. Ready? Shoulders back, rotate your hands, pull your stomachs in, standing legs a little soft as always. And one, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Two, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Three, two, three, only come as high if you can't go higher. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Four, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Halfway, five, two, three, you're doing great. Hold, whoops, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Six, two, three more. Three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Seven, two, you can do anything you want with this hand. Three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Eight, two, three, four, Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Very good. Let's move my chair back. And let's just do with the right leg this time, because we've just worked our left leg. Let's do the front leg raise seated. So when you exercise with this video, you can choose a combination of any of these. But if you do the front leg raise seated, it's pretty hard. You want the weight up here, not on your knee, but a little farther back. Legs extended, you gotta scoot to the edge of the chair. Sorry, I have to scoot back a bit or I'm gonna go out of the picture. All right, scoot it to the front. Check your posture, stomach's pulled in, leg extended. That's hard chair I'm sitting on. And one, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Knee stays straight. Three, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Three, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Let's pause a bit. You're not doing this with this exercise. That's a mistake people make, okay? This exercise is straight leg. Four, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Let's change legs. Five, two, three, four. Hold only to the height of your knee. Five, six, seven, eight. Six, two, three, four. Hold. Five, six, seven, eight. You see me? Seven, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Last one. Eight, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. When you're doing this, you're not leaning back. You're sitting straight and you're only moving your hip. This is great for bone density in the neck of the femur, which is where breaks typically would occur. So if you can take some water, again, you should be thirsty and your mouth should be getting dry if you're talking, if you're counting. Make sure you stay hydrated. There is an exercise to do for knee strengthening, which I don't have the right weight with me, but you'll want a lightweight ankle cuff on, and I don't have my lightweight ankle cuff here, but you're only, this is all you're doing with it. Let's just try that. Let's right now just do four of these. I'm trying to watch the time, but there is no time limit. I think there's no time limit. I guess we can do eight, so let's do eight. One, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Two, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. You can actually scoot back. Three, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Four, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Five, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Six, almost there. Two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Seven, two more. Seven, this is like a rest. Two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Last one. Eight, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Leather leg. One, two, three, four. Hold, five, six, seven, eight. Two, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, three, two, three, four, hold, how's your posture, five, six, seven, eight, four, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, three more, four more, five, two, three, four, hold, five, you're counting, six, seven, eight, we're on six, six, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, almost there, seven, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, last one, eight, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Nicely done, everybody. Take a sip of water. Okay, let's do the shoulder blade squeeze, which is one of my favorites. I think it feels so good. Remember, when you're doing the squeeze, you're not using your arms in any way to get that squeeze. You're just using your back muscles right through here, pulling it right through here. And if someone came into the room and put their fingers back there in the middle of your back, they should feel you tightening around your fingers. And it'll come sometimes because we don't use that muscle. We don't know where it is. We can't feel it at first, but you will eventually. All right, so in this one, it's like the weights are on a table and your arms stay glued to your side. Pretend like you've got a $500 bill between your arms, and the minute it drops, a mouse is going to come and carry it off, and you'll never see it again. So your arms stay glued all the way back. You get to the back and just tighten your back. The whole action's right there. When you come forward, you can stop at the knees. You don't have to go out. This is going to strengthen your arms too if you're using heavy weights. When I use these 10-pound ones that have the wrist cuffs on and I'm doing 12, I really feel it in my arms too. Okay? So, ready, and one, two, three, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight, two, three, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight, three, four, squeeze your back muscles, hold, five, six, seven, eight, four, two, three, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight, five, two, three, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight, more than halfway, six, two, three, four, squeeze, feels good, five, six, seven, eight, seven, two, three, counting, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight, last one, eight, two, three, four, squeeze, five, six, seven, eight, very nice, very, very nice. Okay, let's put those down. Take some more water, please. And we'll just do one more. And maybe at some point I'll add a few more exercises if that becomes possible. And we'll increase the length of the repetition. So make sure you're doing these so that if I do get to the point where I increase the number of repetitions or sets, if we had a second set, you're ready to do that, okay? Right now, let's do the forward arm raise, because if you have shoulder issues and you haven't been able to do some of the other arm ones, this is one you could do as a substitute, or you can do it on its own like we will right now. So we're gonna lift our arms to about under shoulder height, not above that position. You can hurt your shoulders, and then come back down. If you can only get this high, That's okay. You'll eventually get it higher. Okay, so posture, shoulders up, back and down, stomachs in, knees slightly bent always, and one, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. We're going to do four of these tonight. Four, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. Three, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight, four, two, three, four, hold, five, six, seven, eight. I've worked your arms a bit, I've worked your legs a bit. I don't want to push it too much this first time back, although I imagine some of you have been doing these exercises, and I think we've done them all, and all we have left is the cool down. Don, did you be able to find the cool down there? Oh yes, wonderful. Okay, so let's start. I need some water. Before we start, let's get some water. Water, water, water. Can you turn that over? Yeah, let's start over, but a little louder. Can't start over. Here we go. Arms up, deep breath, exhale. Again. Exhale. Extend your leg. Bring your toes back to get that stretch. Back straight, no bending. You've had knee surgery or hip surgery, don't do this one unless your doctor has said you can. You're pushing down slightly, right here. Same thing, other way. Toes up as high as you can get them. Fingertips up. Get those stretches. Big round circles here. We're trying to increase flexibility in our ankles. That helps prevent falls. Reverse that. Other leg. Other leg. Stretching, opening your chest up, it helps prevent that stooping over. Yeah. Stretch up, reach to the ceiling. Other arm. Reach, 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 reach. Higher, higher. Thank you. as you're pulling in with your hand, not on your shoulder, pulling your shoulder back. Reach forward and stretch. Stretch our triceps, get your arm up as high as you can, and come back down in the back. Feel the stretch. Other arm. Let's just get this stretched a little bit more because we kind of speeded that up. Really get these muscles stretched out. They have a tendency to shorten and start coming over. You want to work on that. And open again. Let's do the quad stretch. Either it's seated or standing. Let me turn this way for you. Back, and just lean back and you feel a stretch. Just as far as you can do it, it's fine. Feel the stretch and come right back. So when you go to the one direction, feel the stretch, come back. You don't want to hold that too long. Down and up. Other direction, feel the stretch, and then come back. Drop your ear to the shoulder briefly. Head up. Other direction. And back. Three deep breaths. Exhale. And relax and push out any worrisome thoughts. Deep breath up. And just let any stress fall from your body. One last one. Deep, deep breath. In. Feel your lungs. And exhale. And a big hug. Squeeze, you did a really good job. Good job, nice job. Let me talk to you one more moment. When you do the stretches, do the stretch to the point where you feel the stretch, and that's it. Don't make it hurt, and then come on back. I really would love to see you all again. I look forward to seeing you all at the center. If you need to get in touch with me, just call the center, or not call, email Chris at the center, and ask for my email address, and you can get in touch with me, okay? I miss you all. Bye.